Each person's genome has about 3 million single nucleotide variations, as well as many other types of genetic variations. How do we predict the function of these genetic variations? On May 14, 2013, movie star Angelina Jolie revealed that she has a mutation in her BRCA1 gene and that her mother died early from breast cancer. To reduce her own risk of getting breast cancer, she made the drastic decision to have both of her breasts surgically removed. This revelation sent shockwaves all over the world. Many people wondered and argued whether she had made the right choice. The core of Angelina Jolie's decision touches upon an important bioinformatics question. Given that she has a genetic mutation in BRCA1, what is the conditional probability that she will develop breast cancer? Even with her mutation, there is a chance that she may be cancer-free. These two probabilities add up to one. Before we talk about how to calculate these numbers, let's first look at where our genetic variations come from. We all know that we inherit genetic variations from our parents. If our mother carries a particular mutation allele, there is a 50% chance that we may inherit it from her. Each of us also have over 70 de novo single nucleotide mutations that neither of our parents have. Many severe childhood neurological disorders, such as Rett syndrome, are caused by de novo mutations that disrupted critical genes. Each of us also has somatic mutations that are accumulated during cell divisions. An extreme example of this is cancer, where somatic mutations cause cells to grow uncontrollably. There are many types of genetic variations in the human genome. Different genetic variations may have very different effects on the genome and on the phenotype. The most severe is chromosomal aneuploidy, meaning that a person has one or more copies of actual chromosomes or missing chromosomes. The best-known example is Down syndrome, which is caused by three copies of chromosome 21, or trisomy 21, which almost always have been de novo. We never hear about trisomy 1 or trisomy 2 in humans, because these chromosomes are so large and contain so many genes that having abnormal copies of them is embryonically lethal. Another type of microscopic or submicroscopic genetic variation in the human genome is structural variations. They include deletions, duplications, inversion, insertions, and translocation. Deletion is a type of mutation involving the loss of genetic material. Insertion is a type of mutation involving the addition of genetic material. Many mobile elements are inserted in each of our genomes. A novel sequence, such as virus genomes, are sometimes inserted into our genome. There are two types of genetic duplications. Tandem duplications happen where a segment of a chromosome is duplicated right next to the original copy. Interspersed duplications happen where a segment of the chromosome is duplicated to somewhere else on the genome. Deletions and duplications are often called copy number variations or CNVs. Finally, two other types of genetic structural variation that cause disruptions of the genome, but not genomic balance, include inversions where a segment of a chromosome is inverted, and translocations where a segment of a chromosome is moved to somewhere else on the genome. Short insertions and deletions of one or a few, up to a thousand or several thousands nucleotides, sometimes called indels. Indels may happen in intergenic or intronic regions, or they may happen within protein coding regions. Within protein coding regions, if an indel involves three or multiplicity of three nucleotides, it will only add or delete one or several codons without causing a frameshift. Otherwise, it may cause a frameshift that may result in a complete change of the amino acid sequence. Often it would also cause a premature stop codon. The new protein may not be stable enough to exist at all. At a smaller scale, but with much higher frequency, there are single nucleotide variations. On average, in a person's genome, there is about 3 million SNVs, roughly equivalent to one SNV in every 1,000 nucleotides. SNVs that are known to affect functions and phenotypes the most are located in the promoter regions or protein coding regions of genes. Variations in UTR and intronic regions sometimes also affect function. Most variants are located in intergenic regions between genes. Some of them fall in non-coding RNA that are transcribed but not translated. SNVs within coding regions tend to have larger effects than other variations, and those have been studied the most. In the more severe cases, SNV can cause a premature stop codon that terminates a protein early. In this example shown, the cytosine nucleotide is changed to thymine. As a result, the codon CUG that used to encode amino acid of glutamine, now it becomes TAG, which is a stop codon resulting in premature termination of the protein. This SNV is called a nonsense mutation. Because a nonsense SNV causes premature termination of a protein, it is usually predicted to be damaging, even though there are exceptions where paralogous proteins or alternative pathways can compensate for the loss of a protein. In the second example, the adenine nucleotide is changed to cytosine. As a result, the codon CAT that used to encode the amino acid histidine now it becomes CCT, which encodes proline. This SNV is called a non-synonymous or missense SNV. Because the codons are degenerative, many SNVs do not cause amino acid changes. They are called synonymous or same-sense or silent SNVs. Some SNVs at or near splice junctions may affect splicing. And finally, some SNVs change a stop codon to a codon encoding amino acid, resulting in a lessening of the protein which may have altered or disrupted stability, structure and function. Synonymous, intronic, and intergenic variations are often ignored. However, according to GWAS studies, 88% of trait-associated variations of weak effect are non-coding. Although, individually their functional effects may not be as obvious, because these regions are so large, their total effects cannot be neglected, especially, a mild traits. However, they remain understudied, and better methods are still needed. Most research so far had focused on missense SNVs. A big reason is because known deleterious mutations are enriched in missense mutations. About 50% of all known mutations of Mendelian disorders are missense mutations. However, it is important to note that there might be ascertainment biases because an important discovery tends to attract more research in the same direction. However, not all missense SNVs cause phenotypic changes. For instance, BRCA1 was the first gene associated with breast cancer in 1990 based on linkage analysis of large pedigrees of early-onset familial breast cancer. BRCA1 has a total of 238 known missense mutations, 163 are present only in patients, 62 are present only in healthy persons, and 13 in both patients and healthy persons. Furthermore, even missense variations seen only in patients are not all causal. If we look more broadly, analysis of the whole genomes of over 1,000 healthy individuals in the 1,000 Genome Project revealed that, on average, a healthy individual carries over 3 million SNPs, over 361,000 indels, almost 16,000 deletions, over 400 duplications, and almost 5,000 mobile element insertions. Within protein coding regions, on average, a healthy individual carries large division that disrupt about 150 genes, over 1,000 stop coding SNPs, 77 stop losses, over 900 small frameshift indels, over 700 small in-frame indels, nearly 70,000 non-synonymous SNPs, and 60,000 synonymous SNPs. So, the questions are, what features differentiate disease-causing variants from neutral ones? How can we predict whether a variation is disease-causing? Unlike sequence alignment and sequence database search, the questions here remain largely unsolved. And there's still lots of active researches going on.